In the last video, we saw how two monosaccharides can be joined together to make a disaccharide. In the same way, additional monosaccharides may be added to make longer chains. Chains containing up to about 10 monosaccharide groups are called oligosaccharides, and longer chains are called polysaccharides. The chains can be linear or branched. We will now look at a few important polysaccharides. Monosaccharides can be used to provide energy for the cell, as described later in the course. When these monosaccharides are not immediately needed to provide energy, they can be stored as polysaccharides. The polysaccharide used for this purpose in animals is called glycogen. Glycogen contains chains of 12 to 14 glucose monomers. These are joined via alpha-1,4 linkages, as shown. You can see that these linkages are 1,4 linkages because carbon-1 of one glucose monomer is joined to carbon-4 of the next glucose monomer. In glucose, carbon-1 is the anomeric carbon. Each glucose is in the alpha configuration because the linking oxygen joined to the anomeric carbon, which would be a hydroxyl if the glucose were a monosaccharide, is on the opposite side of the ring to the highest numbered carbon of that same glucose. These chains of 12 to 14 glucose monomers are connected to one another via alpha-1,6 linkages, which act as branch points. There are two branch points on every chain of 12 to 14 monomers. The first glucose chain of about 13 monomers is attached to a protein called glycogenin, represented by the circle containing the letter G in this diagram. The first chain has two alpha-1,6 branch points where new chains of about 13 monomers begin. The pattern continues, forming up to about 12 shells or layers of glucose chains. Only the first 5 shells are shown. All of these glucose units form one large polysaccharide molecule. As described in a later module, glucose monomers are removed from glycogen when the amount of sugar available to cells becomes low. The monomers are removed starting from the ends of the chains on the outside of the glycogen polymer. The structure of glycogen makes many such ends available, allowing rapid release of many glucose monomers from storage. Instead of glycogen, plants use starch to store glucose monosaccharides. Starch is composed of two types of polysaccharide, both of which have similarities to glycogen. Amylose, the first component, makes up about 20-30% of starch. It contains glucose monomers joined in alpha-1,4 linkages with very few branch points. Amylopectin makes up 70-80% of starch. Like amylose and glycogen, amylopectin contains glucose in alpha-1,4 linkages. Unlike amylose, amylopectin has branch points every 24-30 glucose units, at which another glucose is attached via an alpha-1,6 linkage. This is the same type of branch point as is found in glycogen, but there are fewer branch points in amylopectin than in glycogen. Amylose and amylopectin are found together in semicrystalline starch granules. Polysaccharides can also be used for structural purposes. Cellulose, a rigid molecule found in plant cell walls, is a linear polymer of glucose monomers joined via beta-1,4 linkages. Chitin, which forms the exoskeleton of insects, is a linear polymer of N-acetyl-beta-glucosamine. The monomer in chitin is related to glucose but has an N-acetyl group at carbon-2 instead of a hydroxyl group. Even though it deviates from the normal chemical formula of carbohydrates, chitin is still considered a polysaccharide because it is based on a molecule that is very closely related to a monosaccharide. Note that cellulose and chitin cannot be digested by humans because we lack the appropriate enzymes to break the beta-1,4 linkage. Many other oligosaccharides and polysaccharides and related polymers exist that humans have difficulty digesting. These may be broken down by bacteria in the large intestine and are known collectively by the name dietary fiber. We have seen how carbohydrates can be used to store energy and as structural molecules. As noted in the module on membranes, oligosaccharides are also attached to membrane lipids and proteins to protect cells and to mediate cell-cell recognition. Carbohydrates vary widely in structure, and monosaccharide units are joined in many different combinations. At this point, you should have a basic understanding of monosaccharide structure and how monosaccharides are joined together to form more complex molecules.